And apparently did not wear down the knife that time. We're gonna go here. A man clad in black approaches the party. He looks to be a traveling physician. Hello there. I can tend your injuries for a modest price. Yeah, heal everyone for 20. And that will help everyone. Hopefully. The physician thanks the party for their patronage, imploring them to take more care in the future. Yeah, well. It wasn't exactly my fault. A Luna moth? A wedding. Bryce stumbles across an impromptu trail wedding. The crowd is cheering and celebrating the love of a young couple. The party could opt to join in or keep to themselves. Oh, what the heck, let's celebrate. We celebrate by sitting there. The party celebrates with the others late into the night, each group enjoying the other's company. Man, they disappeared. In the morning, the celebrants have cleared out, leaving the party alone on the trail. The group also left a small crate of foodstuffs for the party by way of thanks for the company. Looks like we're gonna have another fishing. Give me a few minutes to fish as much as you can. Yeah, we'll accept. You know, let's try someone other than Annie this time. Catches like one fish and it's like I'm done. Flathead catfish caught. Is that? That's pretty decent. Nope, that one didn't make it. Another one, another long-nosed gar. Yeah, the fish only stick around for so long. Time for one more if I can find a fish. That may be it. Yeah, that's it. Four fish and 75 pounds. Not bad. Welcome back. Let me see what you caught, and I'll let you know how you did. In the meantime, I'm interested to hear how you did. I think I did okay. That's interesting. Always, yeah. More suspenseful, blah, blah, blah. 2,000, yeah, that's okay. I prepared a little something for you as a reward. Hopefully, it'll make up for rushing around chasing fish for me. So, John manages to catch 75 pounds of fish and brings it all back to storage. But thanks to the trap, we get 20 more pounds of fish. We could use the knife. Able to clean all the fish from the bones. We got 3 more fish traps. So really quickly, what all did we get? So we have 95 fish. That's good. We have 4 fish traps now. Even better. So let's go here. Francis spies a wounded jackrabbit limping across the grass off the trail. A swift gunshot wound would put it out of its misery and provide a little food. Who should take the shot? Annie. Seems the gun was not loaded. Yeah, I forgot about that. I forgot we didn't have bullets. But we're fixing to have some more stuff, it looks like. So, delicate. Let's see what Nathaniel can do. It crushes a few in the process, yeah. Yeah. Saw that coming. And it's starting to rain. And lightning frightens the oxen. Party could push past the weather as soon as possible, but it would risk him getting sick. Alternatively, waiting out the storm might be a more viable option. Let's wait out the storm. As everyone climbs into the nearly empty wagon, except for the ox, of course. Party stations are amplified. That's not what they signed up for when they're setting out the journey. Yeah, well. And eventually the rains clear out. some items get damaged. Yeah, they're not doing too stressful of a path anyway, so... Entering Newellsburg. All right. The bustling activity can be heard for several tents that come into view. This appears to be a small trading post of some kind. Let's talk to the bank agent. Strange joking with the travelers. What brings you to these parts? The promise of a new life in Oregon, no doubt. My associate in here, our business. There's a lot of opportunity for investment in the West, and the financial stakes are high. So last time I did the full trail, we talked about Samuel Peppard and we got him the funding. So this time I want to do William Thomas. We met a man at Fort Kearney by the name of William Thomas. He had a fantastic business opportunity. He was looking for investors. It sounded very promising. I'd certainly like to hear more. Why don't you tell us more about the details? What topic should the party talk about? His sales pitch, did I even go over his sales pitch? I just say the generous percentage. Now that's what I like to hear. This is a man after my own heart, canny, brimming with confidence, but not dishonest. I think we should set up a meeting at once. Agreed. I'll collect the bank right away and arrange a meeting. With our backing and experience, the Overland Navigation Company could become a winner. Your assistance is greatly appreciated, friends. Perhaps we'll see each other again. Yeah. So, with that, let's... Yeah, I think we're done with all of that. That was who I wanted to get to. I probably should have visited the store. Now we gotta go to Courthouse Rock. Here is... some berries. Let's do that, because that's... the plains stretch out, and we've got the... Newellsburg is a fading memory. Winter in 185 days. They act like it's going to get cold or something. Wagons failing to lose the purchase on loose dirt on a hill. Annie cries out in pain as the wagon barrels into her. Wow, I can't talk. It's evident that Annie will be unable to walk on her leg without treatment. Someone should examine it. Let's do Nathaniel. Examines the injury. He struggles to determine the extent of the break, but suggests that it be splinted so that Annie will at least be able to walk once again. Here's an idea. How about Annie ride in the wagon? Nathaniel has dysentery. Party spies, some red berries, medicinal properties. Yeah, we're going to definitely harvest those. We'll try John. Notices a handful of old unfired bullets lying beneath the leaves. Gathers many bullets as he deems salvageable. Large number of berries, though he crushes a few in the process. He carries a handful back to the wagon. We get two herbal remedies. So, not too bad. But let's go through really quickly and do these herbal remedies on... in fact, I think we could do a actual medicine on Nathaniel. I've got so much bait. There. It's the miracle cure of that I do not have anything for... There. Let's look and see, do we need... Yeah, we could do this. I started with one harmonica. That's cool. So that gives me a second harmonica. Greetings, traveler. My name is... I'm sorry. I'm not even sure how to pronounce that. It's a pleasure to meet you. We are ill-equipped for trade, but perhaps we could still make an exchange if you are willing. I reserve many of our goods for ourselves, but I will present what we're willing to part with. If you have suitable things to trade, we can make a deal. Trade for 5 blankets. Trade for 6 pelts. Trade for 150 meat. Or 50. Oh, yes, we'd be willing to trade for a number. Yeah, okay, I don't have anything like that. I don't have... Yeah, I don't have anything to trade. Yep, I'm sorry. Oh, no trade today. Nonetheless, it was an enjoyable meeting, travelers. May we meet again. And he has dysentery. Okay. Let's... Let's go back. Okay. Okay, hunting is ideally... Okay, so we do have... Party has 6 bullets, so let's... Beyond examines the hunting grounds ahead of him, it seems like he'll be able to find a few animals. Or remember how to hunt. That's fair, and that's probably actually, I think, yeah, that's all the bullets I've got left anyway. £50. Now, there's that bison had to have had way more than just 50 pounds of meat. After a successful hunt, John carried 50 pounds of meat back to storage. Yeah, because John is wasteful, and he spends time skinning the animals for valuable pelts or pressed down. Yeah, we're going to obtain the pelts. Yes, use the knife. With skilled use of the knife, John salvages some pelts in no time at all. Unfortunately, the process dulls the knife, making it worn. We got 4 pelts. We good, okay. The flower supplies are getting low. Hardtack. Yeah, we're just gonna do it all into hardtack. Flour's baked into a number of dry hard biscuits. Mm-hmm. exhaustion. Treat with coffee. Okay, I can't do that. We're almost to Courthouse Rock. Are those ancient stones in the ruined castle jutting from the earth? No, they are the courthouse and jail rocks, noted landmarks of a decidedly natural origin. Doesn't look like I have anybody to talk with. Yeah, nobody in particular. Let's spend a day and rest. Though on the downside, that does drop our food stores, but how are these people, like, they're just... I swear, they're just like, yeah, collect pelts, collect meat. Well, unfortunately, I don't have any bullets, so there's no point in going hunting. Alright, tunnels westward, far on the horizon, the silhouette of a tall, thin spire becomes barely visible. Oh, here's the... Ladies and gentlemen, we stand at the threshold of a new era in overland transportation. I, William Thomas, am grateful that you could be here to witness it. I present you the Wind Wagon, the very first in a fleet of vessels to be operated by my Overland Navigation Company. Naturally, I owe my success to my friends here, who presented my plan to these fine bank representatives. After I demonstrate how the vehicles operated, you may have the honor of being the first passengers. Do you have any questions before I begin my demonstration? What should the party say? Very well, let the demonstration begin. Watch closely because history is about to be made. Yes, it is. Sail on! See, the difference is that Pepper had a part. This guy, they're all in it for the money. Minor setback, ladies and gentlemen. You know what they say? Fail fast and fail often. Or was that sail fast? Regardless, this won't affect our business plan in the long term. The tornado has also demonstrated the Wind Wagon's ability to be disassembled into easy-to-store parts. I'm prepared to offer 10% of gross sales. I assume that's agreeable. Yeah, good luck on that. But that quest is complete. Pepper's Folly. I wonder if that's because I basically turned against thing. You must let us through. Okay, yeah, this is effectively the soldiers don't want to pay the toll, and the Native Americans of the Lakota are basically like, dude, everyone pays the toll, even our own people, even our, everyone pays it. It's not just a you thing. And the American soldiers are like, oh, but we should be able to go and we should be able to go wherever we want. And, you know, it's not on you. It's on us. And we're going to be doing this great treaty that they're probably not going to agree, that they're not going to follow anyway. I do need to speak to the U.S. soldier first. Or did I already speak to the U.S. soldier? And the soldier's like, well, we don't have the funds for it. And I'm personally like tough because, you know, it's a toll road. It's the price that they're asking. They're not giving you a special consideration. We're going to side with We're siding with the Native Americans because that's what the right thing to do. Who should convince them to do that? We'll do Annie. Hopefully, maybe. Maybe she's got some. Quit three. I understand your argument. I certainly don't wish for conflict. So, but it becomes a peaceful resolution, at least. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and leave. Yeah. So we're gonna kind of, some of the stuff that I've already gone through, we're gonna really just kind of speed run through. Coyotes, we have horses. Yeah, you know what? We're gonna go ahead and rest a little bit. Give the ox a chance to get some food and stuff. Because it's important for them. Now we're running low on food again. My usual strategy with Oregon Trail has always been, oh look, we have hunting grounds, but possibly hunting grounds. Deer spotted swarm, an infernal buzzing fills the air, swarms of flies, but the bird is disgusted by the future. So my standard thing, especially in Oregon Trail 2, was always to, at the very beginning in Independence, was to buy as many livestock as possible. Because it's a matter of, I mean, keeping them fed, they can eat grass on the side of the road, they can have a little bit of a break, and they're usually pretty good to go. And it's literally the cost of food and upkeep. But you could trade them for practically anything. Arriving at Chimney Rock, a towering stone spire erupts from the earth ahead. At its base is a large mound, and though the massive pillar was once a single mountain, now sculpted to a fine point, this is Chimney Rock, one of the trail's most storied landmarks. I don't believe we have anything. Yeah, we don't have anybody to talk to. I mean, we probably could talk to people. We're just gonna keep going. And Fort Laramie. We're gonna do fish. Once there was a guiding beacon, nothing now lies before the party but the endless plains. And of course now we have no food. And they have dysentery.